Hello students, welcome to our today's class. In the today's class we are going to focus on the differences between white phosphorus and red phosphorus. Very important topic. So 2-3 points are there for competitive examination. So for that point of view we will focus on this concept. Very simple and easy concept. Focus one by one. So differences wise, if you take first one, white phosphorus is poisonous. Okay, so it is a poisonous, whereas coming to the red phosphorus is non-poisonous. This is poisonous and this is non-poisonous. Simple way you can remember. The second one is, here the units present in the white phosphorus. Here the monomer units are present. Monomer units of P4 molecules present. You know very well about P4 molecule structure. This is the P4 molecule structure. So P4 molecule. So it is present like this. Monomer units are present in the white phosphorus. Whereas coming to the red phosphorus having polymer units of P4 molecule. Polymer unit of P4 molecule means you can take like this. Here polymer unit of P4 molecule. So like this type of polymers are present in this red phosphorus, like this type of chains are present. So due to the monomer units, it's a more reactive. Due to containing this polymeric structure, it is less reactive. You must remember the reactivity we can explain with the help of structures also. This is very important. Why white phosphorus is more reactive than red phosphorus? Reason is what? It is having monomer units, whereas coming to here polymer units. So that's why monomer units are more reactive than the polymer units. You can take based on structure also, we can explain that. Now it's a physical appearance you take. It is a waxy solid. Now here if you take third point, what is its physical appearance? It is a brittle powder. Okay, powder. Now whereas coming to here, it is less stable. Why? We already discussed, it is having monomer units of what? P4. So it's more reactive means what? Less stable. You can say simply less stable. And here you take simply here, what is that fourth one? So less stable means obviously due to its here chain structure and all, less reactive, that means more stable. Now you take next one, what is that next one? Fifth point, if you take solubility, okay, insoluble in what? Water. But soluble in CS2. Very important point. That is, this is insoluble in water but soluble in CS2. But whereas if you take, it is insoluble in water and CS2. In both it is insoluble. Have you got it? Sixth point in red phosphorus is, you can take, it is a less reactive, and this is more reactive. So more reactive, here some examples we need to learn here about the reactivity of white phosphorus. So white phosphorus, if you take P4, it is reacting with oxygen, quickly reacting with oxygen, and it is converting as like a P4O10, okay, phosphorus pentoxide. So this is, you can take it as like example one. Second example is, if you can take second example, that is when white phosphorus react with base, that means you can take NaOH 3 moles, okay, and it is giving what? Phosphine gas, that is PH3 plus sodium hypophosphite. So 3 moles you can take here. Yeah, this is phosphine gas, and if you take this one, this is sodium hypophosphate. Sodium hypophosphate. Last point is here, that is seventh point, white phosphorus glow in dark. It glows in dark. Okay, simply it glows in dark. But whereas coming to the red phosphorus, it does not. So these are the differences between white phosphorus and red phosphorus. Now we have to discuss about the conversions from white phosphorus to red phosphorus to black phosphorus. Here I want to tell you one major point. White phosphorus also call it as like a yellow phosphorus, because it turn it as like yellow while exposing to the environment, it turns to yellow. That's why white phosphorus we can also call it as like a yellow phosphorus, right? Now conversion of white phosphorus to red phosphorus to black phosphorus and types of black phosphorus, these points we need to discuss now. First you take white phosphorus on heating at 573 Kelvin in inert atmosphere, if you heat it, white phosphorus at 573 Kelvin, it turns to the red phosphorus. It turns to the what? Red phosphorus. It turns to the red phosphorus. Now, this red phosphorus, whenever you heat it at a high pressure, you need to use that high pressure. If you heat this red phosphorus at high pressure, it turn it as like a black phosphorus. This black phosphorus existing in two forms, that is here you can take it, this is alpha black phosphorus, and next one is second one, beta black phosphorus. So now we need to discuss about how can we get this alpha and beta. So for example, if you take here first one, you can get this what alpha phosphorus from the red phosphorus. You have to remember, this is very important point. So red phosphorus, from the red phosphorus you can get directly alpha black phosphorus. How can we get this? Very simple, we need to heat that at 803 Kelvin. Red phosphorus, if you heat it at 803 Kelvin, so you can get this alpha black phosphorus. Whereas coming to the beta black phosphorus, how can we get this beta black phosphorus? When you heat white phosphorus at 473 Kelvin by using high pressure. Okay, white phosphorus, if you heat it at 473 Kelvin temperature, by using high pressure it converted into beta black phosphorus. Whereas coming to here, red phosphorus if you heat at 803 Kelvin if you heat it in the sealed tube. So in the sealed tube, if you heat it, it converted as like a alpha black phosphorus. It is converted as like a beta black phosphorus. Have you got it? One more important point is here, it does not oxidize. It does not oxidize. Okay. Whereas coming to here, it does not burn. It does not burn up to 673 Kelvin. It does not burn. Very simple. White phosphorus you take and heat it at up to 573 Kelvin in an inert atmosphere in several days. If you heat it like that, white phosphorus will be converted into red phosphorus. Then red phosphorus, if you heat it at high pressure, here it is converted to black phosphorus. Black phosphorus exists in two forms, that is alpha black phosphorus and beta black phosphorus. If you want to get alpha black phosphorus directly, you can heat red phosphorus at 803 Kelvin in sealed tube. Whereas coming to the white phosphorus, if you heat at high pressure at 473 Kelvin, directly you can get black phosphorus. So here alpha black phosphorus and beta black phosphorus. Alpha black phosphorus does not oxidize in air. Now, whereas if you take beta black phosphorus, it does not burn up to 673 Kelvin. So this is about our today's class.